Today we are going to learn how to create a sign-in application in Java. Sign-in application means this application will ask user to enter email address and password, and that entered email password is compared with the email and password which is stored already in MySQL database. That is that email and address which the user stored while filling up the sign-up form. If the email and password which is entered now in sign-in application matches with the email and address which is stored in the database, the application will display welcome message, otherwise it will display sorry sir, you are unauthorized, right? So let's see how this application is created step by step.
Hi, today I am going to teach you how to create a sign-in form in Java. Whatever application you make, you always want a sort of a form which authenticates the user. That is, you want only authorized person to use your application, right? And we see it across in every application. This is the code for signing in into a form. But we'll do it practically. To create Java program, I'm using NetBeans IDE. NetBeans IDE is the wonderful IDE that gives you one platform to type the program, edit Java program, debug and run it, right? The first step is to create a project. So click on File menu, New. From the Categories pane, you click on Java, and because we are creating a Java desktop application, select Java application from the Projects pane, click Next. It is asking you the name of the project. Suppose we give it the name, say, Sign In App, let it be. These are the fields that determine where your project will be stored on your local hard disk. Let them to their default values, click on Finish. NetBeans will create a Java class file for you, signinapp.java. This is automatically created for you. At the moment it is empty. If I run this project right now, it won't give you any output. Because my project is a GUI based, graphical user interface based, so I need to add one JFrame form to this application. So I click on this package, signinapp, click on New, select JFrame form. It is asking you to name the JFrame form. Let us give the name as, say, authentication. Click on Finish. This is the JFrame form created for you. There are always two modes for working with JFrame form. One is design mode, where you drag and drop your swing controls over here. And this is a source mode, where you can see the Java code that is auto-created for you. For the control that you drag and drop, NetBeans will automatically create the code for you. So let's design the GUI form. I'll drag and drop one label control over here. Again, one more label control. I'll be asking the user to enter email address and password, right? So I'll be taking one text field swing control. This is the text field. I'll drag and drop here. And because I don't want the password to be displayed on the screen, I'll be taking this password field. I won't be taking this text field. I'll be taking the password field so that when the user enters the password, only asterisk or dots be displayed. Nobody should be able to see the text that is being entered as the password. And here, this is the button. On clicking this button, the authentication procedure will start. And to display the message that whether the user is authenticated or not, I need another label form. So these are the controls that I've dragged and dropped on the JFrame form. Initially, these controls are very small in size. So I'll increase its font size. So I'll select all of them, click and drag method. I clicked all of them. From here, the properties window, I select this font property. Let us increase the font size 14. So it has become visible now. This is the default text, J label 1 for the first label that I have dragged and dropped. I want to overwrite this text. So right click on this J label form, select edit text option. I'll type it as sign in form. Here I'll again edit text, I'll write email address to tell the user that I want the email address to be entered here. This is for the password. Here I'll make it submit button. I don't want the default text in this text field. I want the user to enter email address over here. So right click here, edit text and delete it. This is the password field, and again I resize it and make it bigger, and I don't want these password to be displayed, I will delete this. And this is my label to display whether the user is authenticated or not. I don't want this default text to appear. Click edit text, delete this text, increase its width. Acha, this is the text field, right? The default name of this text field is JTextField1. Can you see it here? I don't want this. I want some reasonable name. I'll change this variable name. I'll right click on this text field. Click on change variable name. I'll name it as JTextField email address, so that the person should know what is this text field for. I'll rename this password field also. Right click on this. Select change variable name. Make it J password field. That's enough. This button, I'll change its name to J button submit. Okay. This label field, which is supposed to display the response of authentication procedure, I'll change its name to J label response. Okay. So my form is ready. I need to write the code. Let me tell you that I have already created one database shopping cart in MySQL server. I am using MySQL database server for this project. I assume that you have seen my earlier videos of how to insert rows into the MySQL database. If you haven't seen it, please use the links that I am showing it over here. Watch those videos. You'll be able to know how the data is inserted into the MySQL database tables and even how the database tables are created. This sign-in form will do what? Will ask the user to enter email address and password and will compare the email address and password which was entered earlier. If email address and password matches, it will show welcome message to the user. Otherwise, it will show the message that you are unauthorized, right? So here, I'll show you what is the database I have already created. This is the shopping cart database I have already created. And in this shopping database, I have created one table, users table, with two columns, email address and password. And in this table, I am right clicking using view data option to show you what are the rows that I have already inserted for you. I have inserted two rows already in this users table. Entered one email address at bmharwani@yahoo.com with the password diamond, and another email address is bintu@gmail.com and password gold. So I can use either of the row, right? So this is the database already created, right? Now let me write the code for it. I need to write the code on this submit button. Double click onto it. NetBeans will create one method for you, jButtonSubmitActionPerformed method. And whatever code you will write over here will be automatically executed when any user will click on the submit button. This is the code that I have already written for you. Let's do one thing. First run it and then we'll see how it is working. So let's copy this code. I'll paste it in the NetBeans here. On the next page also, there's this code. Let's copy this one also. I'll paste it over here. See. Right? Can you see the code over here? This is the code, right? It's giving you an error here that I'm not finding the what's the meaning of this connection class. So click over here. It is asking you to import this java.sql.connection. You click here. Library is automatically added to your form. See, this is that at the top. Can you see that? Again, you come here. There's certain some more errors. It is asking you that I'm not able to understand this driver manager. It is asking you to import this java.sql driver manager. Click over here. This error is gone. Again, here it is giving you some error. You just click on this red icon. It is asking you to import this java.sql prepared statement. Click over here. The error is gone again. It is telling you that I am not finding the meaning of the result set. You click over here. It is asking you to import the java.sql.resultset library. It is imported. And again, here it is giving you certain errors. Click over here. Import the SQL exception. SQL exception is for displaying the error messages. The label response. It will display you the error, right? Let's run this, right? Right click on this. Run file option. See, the application has run and it is asking you to enter the email address and password. Suppose I enter the email address as bmharwani@yahoo.com and the password as say diamond. This was the password that I entered it. Submit. Exception. This is the error that I'm getting it. Why? See, you are accessing MySQL from Java, right? So you need one connector, Java MySQL connector, which is not there, which is not there in this project. So you have to add one MySQL Java connector to establish the interaction between Java and MySQL, right? So what I'll do, I'll right click here on libraries, click on add jar / folder option. This is the MySQL connector Java file which I have already downloaded from the internet. Click here, click on open. This connector file is copied into the project. Now Java will be able to interact with the MySQL. Let's run it again. See, it is asking you to enter the email address and password. Say email address is, and the password is, say, diamond. See, welcome. And if I enter something, some wrong password, see, sorry, you are unauthorized. So this program is working perfectly well. Let's understand the code. First of all, you are loading the MySQL JDBC driver. JDBC means Java Database Connectivity. It is through this driver that Java will be able to interact with the MySQL database, which is at the backend. Next, you have to inform Java to which MySQL database you want to establish the connection. So here it is, this line. See what you're saying, that establish the connection with the local host. The database that I have already created is shopping cart, and it is on this local host. And this is 3306 is the port through which MySQL interact, right? If my MySQL is on some remote host, I have to write the IP address of the remote host where my MySQL is database is there. So at the moment I have written local host. What I'm saying that please establish the connection with the shopping cart database of MySQL server. The username and password is this one, through which the connection will be established. After that, I'm writing one string query, that is the SQL statement. So this is the SQL statement that is accessing the email address and password from users table, where email address matches with the email address that is entered in the text field, right? To run this query, you need one prepared statement object. So you're making one statement object of prepared statement class, and you're passing this SQL query to it. After that, you are invoking the execute query method of this prepared statement class to execute that SQL statement. And whatever the result of that SQL statement is there, if any of the rows matches with this SQL statement, that rows will be assigned to this result set object. That is, if any of the email address and password matches with the email address that is being supplied by the user, that number of rows will be assigned to this result object, which is of result set class. If result dot next, that is, if there's even a single row in result object, it will go into this if loop, and if none of the row is accessed through this SQL statement, it will display the message, this email address is not registered. That is, none of the row is found which matches with this email address or password. But if there is a single row, it will go into this if block. What you are doing, you are accessing the password which is in the database. That is, through this result object, you are accessing the password and assigning it to this dbase password. Dbase password is a variable, is a string variable. Secondly, what you are doing, you are accessing the password which is entered in the password field by the user and assigning it to this entered password. So there are two strings. One is dbase password, which contains the password which was entered in the database. Another is entered password, which is the password which is entered by the user in the password field. If both of them matches, you are displaying through the label response control, you are displaying the message welcome. And if it doesn't matches, you are displaying the message sorry, you are unauthorized, right? So this is the program, and here these are the catch statements. If the library is not found, if the user's table is not found, or if there is some error while accessing the row, you get this error message that exception occurred while searching in the user's table. If you find any problem in understanding this program, you can mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. For the code also, you can mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.